Welcome, family. We're on our way now to the house, the Moses Myers house. Here, of course, let me see if I can share my camera. It is currently raining. Cats and dogs, and they just issued a flood warning, not for the area, not for our area, but we're close to the area, but not for the area that we're headed to. But for the another area, like near Yorktown.
No, it's not fun here.
So we're headed there. What a beautiful day for it, too. I should say a beautiful day for a rain day. You want to go? Oh, I think it's on. Let me go. Nobody should be stranded out in the rain like that. I feel just horrible. Y'all can see how the weather is.
Here,
hold it over towards the window.
I want to hold the camera. I want to hold the camera.
It is raining cats and dogs. It's time to be in the house, but we're out.
Traffic is crazy on our way back.
So earlier, I'm trying to get my thoughts together because I forgot what I was going to say about anyway, my package for me making those necklaces have came in, and I'm going to start immediately making a whole bunch of those up. And I will showcase it online, right here on my channel. And these are going to be I call them mindfulness necklaces to remind you to always go within, and when you're making decisions, to as a form of protection, advice before you get into anything, remember yourself first. And be careful before you decide to turn that corner and go down that dark alley or the well-lit road. Because things happen in the light more than we know. So the dark and the light are similar, right? So I wish I wrote it down what I was going to say. Just totally, it's out of my mind. About was how people, are going to be forced to put themselves in a situation where their discomfort is going to, their well-being. And that doesn't make any kind of sense at all. When you're forcing something upon someone and that thing is an interference in their comfort and their well-being. So it goes to show a lot. It goes to show a lot. But like I said, this is nothing new. This is the same old, same old. Not caring about anyone else but self. And This has been what this country has been founded upon, basically, unfortunately. Just, if you want to look at it in terms of what the message is, everybody been together in this country, but that's not what the premises is based off of. The premise is based off of everybody been together, yeah, but taking advantage of a certain group of people and controlling and outlining their lives in a way that pulls them down in a cesspool of destruction and lies. So that's what has happened to us. That's right, I can't get music while I'm under this tunnel.
one is that someone said something.
What they said?
They said, tell me about this house and where it is. That's Wiseman.
Oh, she said, tell you about the house.
Mm-hmm. And where it is.
Where it's at?
Mm-hmm.
It's on Freemason Street, and we're headed there now. In Norfolk, Virginia. It belonged to Moses Myers. They had 9 children. That's not. We're headed to the house now, and he was an importer, an exporter of you know, different variety of things. That's how he got his wealth. And of course they had slaves, and then they lived, the house next door was Freeman's. We're gonna look at the property next door to his property as well. I think we'll be able to see the kitchen. I think we're gonna be able to see the kitchen. Hopefully we'll have a tour guide this time. Many times that we went before, we didn't have someone, but I've been to the house before, on a class field trip, and we had a tour guide to tell us, you know, things about the house. We can really actually break down everything and tell you it's more, how do I say? It's more informational and more detailed, definitely detailed. And it's almost as if, you know, because they know more about it. The place. Hey there, Prince of Penelia. How is everyone today? See, it's not even doing all that raining over here, and that's a good thing. But over there on the other side, that rain is crazy. And I told the girls, make sure you bring something to cover your heads, because I knew it's going to rain today. It's going to be raining all day. And this is like, rain day is good for reading books, cozying up with some hot cocoa or some tea, and or sleeping, or catching some old classic movies. I love the old movies. You had an urge to set it on fire. Yes, I be getting so angry. Oh my goodness, when I went with the class, when I was going to school, I was like, it's just this urge came over me like, oh, why? Why do we have these places? But, you know, our purpose in going is different. It's like, we don't care about necessarily them, but we do care about our people and their souls. And we care about, perhaps maybe we can find out some information, you know? That's why I want you guys to send me those questions before I go to the, because I know this place may not be that, at least this time of the day that we're going, you know, let me see if they're going to let me by. So I got to get around this car. Yeah, and let me by. Ooh, I don't know what's going on. But this place, when I went to it before, I didn't get much from it. But we're going to see. We're going to see. We're going to try again and see. Because I did post this place on my YouTube, on my Facebook, I mean, years ago, about 6 or 7 years ago, when I first started this journey. And here we are again. Yeah, okay. Thank you for that question. I'll ask that and I'll have them because I'll only have a pendant and I might have to give them some numbers and let them say yes or no, because all they can do, once we see if there's a spirit, because the pendant, you're going to see it. If the pendant moves crazily in the air, then that means that there is something there. So the first question is definitely going to be, is there anyone here? Who are you? And then I would have to, you know, ask them to say yes or no to my question of are you, were you a slave owner or slave? Where we can actually hear them talking to us. But because I'm using my phone as a camera and I got to learn to do my vlogging camera immediately because I'm going to need it for the next trip. The next trip ain't going to be for a while because I'm going to have to do some research and well, no. Actually, the next trip could be the Virginia Beach Witch Duck. It could be the Witch Duck. Y'all, I'm gonna turn off this camera until we get to the place. And I'm just, y'all just gonna hear my voice for a second. That way I can drive. So the next one will probably be the ferry plantation. So I'll probably do that in 2 weeks. Or I'll probably do that towards the end of the month. Yeah, I'll probably do that towards the end of the month. And, oh, yeah. Yeah, always be safe. Yeah, always will be safe. Yeah. But we're now in Norfolk, and we're headed down Granby. I take Granby Street because it's easier to get my way from there to Freemason and to all the other roads. I need to go to Pitt Monticello, which is all the way down. Let me put back on some music. Norfolk is another, it floods here like crazy in Norfolk. That's the problem. I don't know what happened. Somebody say something. Okay. It's not that I know you. Yeah, silly. Yeah, Monticello. Or several or whatever. I fall for you every time I try to resist you. We can get away. Palm trees, beach views, on an every day. All I want to hear is in the visions of Monticello, or whatever they call it. However they say it, Monticello. Okay, I'm gonna give y'all some more views. I'm gonna go ahead and let y'all see the outside, but I'm gonna let my daughter hold it. Here, Reed. Thank you. of my birth. Just like the day that I met you.
The day of the forever. I got you up, but that'll last forever. School outside. Like when you walked out the line.
When you walked out my life.
You like this every time.
Don't mess with me. Just leave it alone. Come on, don't mess with me. I have some fun. Monticello, and it might have been easier on me. I'm trying to see. How did we do this the other day? We came from here. Yeah, we came from here. It might be a little bit easier. If I see Bosch and I know where I'm at. Okay, the name. There it goes. That, no, that's Brambleton. Okay, Brambleton. And then I guess we go down a little bit. Thank you. Oh, yeah, Mount Vernon. Definitely Mount Vernon. Yeah. Yeah, I've been looking at that one. And from what I was told, that. I'm beginning to think up would have been better going that way, because I'm thinking that, but it doesn't matter, because what I can do is still turn off the, how come this light takes forever? I can turn when I get down here, find a parking spot, because I'm thinking it's, where is Freemason? Charlotte Street. And just to recap what I was just, we're getting about, really, really close.
I want you to hear this and hear me very clearly. First time stroke sufferers, three-quarters.
Okay, we're here.
77% of those patients had a blood pressure that was higher
than
40 over 90. Normal is 120 over 80.
We're
the
here.
The best way to avoid a stroke is to lower your
so
blood
let me
pressure.
See if I can turn. Or what you eat, I know what I'm going to need to do. This is Freemason, so that's the house over there. We made it. We made it. We made it.
Yay. Diet soda. Drink at least one diet soda a day. Can triple your stroke risk. Triple it. And get this, here's another study right here. This study shows that daily diet soda drinkers are 3 times more likely to develop dementia. So the best thing for you to do, just stay away from sweetened beverages altogether. Dr. Radio Channel 110 for more like that.
Okay, we're gonna do our turn. Get down here. I hate that I'm going in the wrong direction, but I'm gonna, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna down here, but they let me turn, I go around the corner, and then I can find a good parking spot. But that was easy. I said I can turn here. You know what? I'm gonna turn here. Yes, that saved us some time instead of me going around the corner. We're only going to have an hour as it stands because they close at 5. And that's all we really need. We don't need that much long. Like, I'm not going to stay there long. The tour is real quick. It doesn't take that long at all. Of course, this is Freemason. Matter of fact, I could park inside the mall. And they said until 6. It's only $1 the whole time, whole day, basically, until 6. And then after 6, they charge $2. But then, again, I don't even have to go there and park. But it's better to be safe than sorry, you know what I'm saying? See, I don't know if I go this way to park. Can I go here? Service area only. Okay. So I might as well park somewhere down this road. They have the nice little parking meters. Yeah, because that's the house right there. See, the neighbors don't live there no more because they, because they tore that down and built the mall. You know what? I'm like, do I want to? Yeah, it's more convenient because we're right here. We can go inside and here, Reema, hold the camera up to the window. Let me park. I think we're going to be able to do the meter if they car. This is nice to meet you. Just 10 cars. Or maybe do, I'll do about 2 hours. But if I park in the mall, we can park, we can do it all day.
What do you think? Yeah, pop to the park. Mom, I'm getting tired of holding this.
Okay, what well, here?
Let's park girl. Sorry. Yeah. And it's right next to don't do that.
Yeah, it's only $1 to $6, and I won't have to worry about a meter. Come and worry about a meter all the time. So let me go around the corner, and we'll go ahead and park in the mall. Let me see. Where is this parking at? This is historic area all up and down here. Okay, I think I can park. I think I can go here to park. They said this is a one way, but oh my God.
We have to walk on with
them. Can I go? No. Oh, did I mess up somehow? I hope there's a park in the back here. I hope I didn't come the wrong way. Oh, yeah, there is mall parking back here. Yeah, this is by everything. And it's by the house. I didn't know the house was right there. So all we got to do is come back out and yeah, the house is all brick. Oh, Sharon, I'm sorry. Hold on. We got what? Visa. So all we got to do is come down the stairs and we'd be here pretty much. And we just walk around. Walk around the corner. Let's see. Or we could take the elevator. And we got a nice little parking spot right here. It doesn't matter, right? Yeah. All right. So we're here, family. Let's go. Let's go. I'm going to leave my whatchamacallit here because it's free until we get back. And all I have to carry is my supplies. And my face mask. Okay. Riva, hold on. Here. All right, finally, we're here. Turn off the lights because my car is crying. And I'm going to keep this ticket here so that we can know where it's at when we come back and we can check out. And it's only $1 till $6. We're not going to be here till 6. All right, let's get on the road here. That's not a bad deal. $1 till $6 the whole time.
It used to be, well, no, it's always been like that. It's just these other parking spots you got to be careful of. The mall is usually really... Where, Sean, where are we going at? We're supposed to go down this thing. Hopefully we can get over there. But I have a feeling we have to take that one-way road. Well, they may have a sidewalk. Or we just might... Well, it's just right here. Let's see. The house is right there. We might have to walk around. Either we can go that way or we can walk around. I don't want to walk on the grass. Let's just walk. We'll walk to there and then we'd be right next door to the house. You'll see it in a minute. You think it's night already, all the cricket sounds. That's good. So that's the mall and the mall parking. And this is the Freemason Street. And they got some houses on the other side, way down there. We're going to walk down there too. So that's why I needed the park in the mall, because the time is going to be more than just an hour. I don't know, Shanna. We're going to find out. No, they didn't call it a haunted house. They call it a historical Jewish museum. Jewish history museum. Okay, y'all get to see the beautiful outdoors part of it. The beautiful backyard of it. Somebody left the house gate open. See the backyard?
Oh no. I'm going in there.
We're gonna go there then. First we wanna go to the house.
We're going in this house. It looks like you can't go that way.
Can't go that way.
He just shows you. They build it so that you can look and not.
Okay, we're going this way, about Shana. Ooh. Good. All right, so I'm gonna be here.
Oh, a short block.
Turn handle and push. Okay. Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Welcome to the Moses Fires House. How
Thank
are
you. Today? We're great. We're great.
Are you all members with us or visitors today?
Just visiting.
Thank you for visiting us.
Thank you.
Can you guys in here?
Okay.
I accidentally took the studio. We're not in the studio. We are at the Moses Fires. Sorry.
No, here you're fine.
And may I just have your zip code, please?
23666.
Thank you.
Okay.
Well, welcome to our museum. Have you all ever been here before?
I have. Yeah, she has, but she was a baby.
Hi, welcome back. Well, this is a free museum to tour. If you like what you see, we do accept donations.
Okay.
For our benefit, I'd like to give you a brief introduction to the house.
Yes.
And then you have a choice of going through self-guided or having a tour. We do close at 5.
Yeah.
So I'll just try to go fast.
Okay.
So this is the home of a man named Moses Myers. You'll see his portrait in the next room.
Mm-hmm.
He was born in New York City in 1752.
Mm-hmm.
He built his life and career as a maritime merchant. But when he was a young man in his early 20s, along came a little thing called the American Revolution. He enlisted, but he soon found that he could better aid the cause of American freedom by using his shipping contacts as a blockade runner. After the war, though, he was captured, he went bankrupt, and he had to find a place to rebuild his life and career. And that's when he moved here to Norfolk, Virginia. He moved here in the summer of 1787 with his lovely wife Eliza, and they became Norfolk's first permanent Jewish resident. They built this home in 1792, and they're the only family to own it. It came to the museum in 1931. We'll let you guys go through.
Okay, thank you. Okay. He's so silly there for now. So do y'all ever, is this place considered?
Do you want to make sure we don't touch any of the
No, don't touch nothing.
Thank you, though. So
is this place kind of, have y'all had people come and do investigations to see if it was haunted? Haunted? Yeah.
So, interestingly, actually, Christine and I can both tell you of the sighting that we saw. We tell it a little differently. So there are a couple of things that have happened with the family that could give rise to, like, ghost stories. So one of them, if you come back in here, I'll tell you this story.
Okay.
So, on May 11th, 1811, Sam Myers, the second eldest son of the family, had come home from college, and he was here visiting home. His dad, Moses Myers, got attacked in the middle of the street by a man by the name of Richard Bowden. So Richard Bowden came up behind him, hit him with his cane, and he beat Moses so badly that Moses had to be carried back home. Well, the very same night, Sam grabbed one of his father's pistols.
Is that 13?
It is. So Sam grabbed one of his father's pistols, marched into Richard Bowden's county house, and murdered him. And he was indicted on murder charges. The charges were later lowered to manslaughter, and eventually he was acquitted. So even though he actually killed Richard Bowden, nobody was ever brought to justice for it. So this leads us to our first ghost story, which actually took place upstairs. So I'm going to tell it Christine's way. And that is to say that our friend Jeff, who used to work here, was sitting upstairs one day on the landing, and he's looking out the window, and he sees somebody in the reflection of the glass walk right behind him. He couldn't really tell who it was, just that they had black pants on. Well, we went back to the museum, and we told Christine, and Christine's like, oh, you're crazy, Jeff, you're imagining things. So the next week, Christine was here, and you tell them what you saw.
Well, it was actually several months later.
Months later.
I forgot about it. And I was opening up the upstairs, and I always get a weird feeling in one of the bedrooms up there, so I always go in through a different bedroom to get some windows open before I go into that bedroom. And as I was circling back out towards that same landing where our coworker was before, I saw a figure walk in front of the doorway, right in the door. And at first I thought it was Jeff, my coworker, trying to scare me.
Right.
So I slink behind it, thinking that's sneaky, he's trying to scare me. I slink behind it to the dead end room where he went into, and there was nothing there. And all I could really pick out was that it had black pants.
So
I saw it next.
Wow.
The same ghost. I was going through the back of the house, walking forward, and I saw a man walk across the landing wearing black pants. And I thought it was Jeff. And I go to chase him, and it wasn't Jeff. Jeff was all the way downstairs. So three of us saw the same ghost, black pants ghost is what we call him. And we don't know who he is, but it could be Richard Bowden, the guy
who
Sam murdered.
I think it was. So, you know, I've had experiences too. When I went to the Ferry House Plantation. We went there for Halloween. She was a baby at the time. But we went there, we parked the car, and they were doing shooting canyons on the on one of the boats. And I thought that somebody was doing like a reenactment or a festivities or something for Halloween.
It was just
I had seen the apparition
Oh my God.
Of the ships that wrecked in the canyons.
The Ferry Plantation has a long history of hauntings.
So, I wanted to do a little investigation and see if we can get some questions.
Things do you have there?
I just have cards, but I really want to work with the pendant only right
okay.
now today.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah, because I just want yes and no questions from the spirit if it's
of course,
in there.
Of course.
Well, so I've had the same, y'all not crazy. I've had the same experiences, and these things do happen, but I've had actual a spirit inside the car with me trying to get my attention, and I was like in Hawaii, and I was just like, you know, coming from a photo shoot, and I was just in my own little world, just admiring the island and driving on Pearl Harbor.
Oh, wow.
And it was growling, it was making smells.
Oh my gosh.
It was messing with my hair.
Okay. I'm sorry.
Okay.
I have to move my car real quick.
You're fine.
She's telling us about an experience.
Yeah, in Hawaii. I was on Pearl Harbor and something got in the car with me. And I didn't notice it really until it started breathing in the seat next to me. And my friend even mentioned, he said, "Who's in the car with you?" I was on the phone and he was like, "Is somebody talking to you?" I'm like, "No, I don't hear anything."
Wow.
He heard talking.
Yeah.
I only heard the breathing when I got off the phone, and I was looked over,
yeah.
and the breathing, I heard it all along, but you know, in your subconscious, you're not really paying attention.
Yeah. Wow.
You just got a lot on your mind. When I looked over, I didn't see anything. I just heard breathing coming from nowhere.
That's creepy.
And I told it to get out, that's all. Because at the time, I wasn't aware of these things
right.
happening to me. So now I'm aware, so now I wouldn't tell it to go away anymore. I want information.
Yeah, you want to, yeah, get some
yeah.
information.
I even had a spaceship experience as well.
Yeah.
So
that's cool.
The unknown, the realms of the unknown.
Yeah.
Who's
happening. That? So yeah, on the right, that's Eliza. That's Moses's wife.
It makes your reality altered, don't it? When you
it does
see
that,
and you know
yeah.
you saw that?
Yeah.
There's been people that say
please don't touch anything.
Don't touch
nothing. Touch
they've seen George Washington, or they've seen Edgar Allan Poe on the university
okay.
up
yeah.
there.
Yeah.
And then they realize it's not anyone there.
I've heard Gettysburg.
Mm-hmm.
That people often talk about,
mm-hmm.
you know, thinking that there's a reenactment. Nobody, there's no reenactment.
Right.
There. Yeah, I've heard of those stories.
Yeah.
Well, and seeing the figure wasn't the only. I mean, there are a lot of stuff over the years. I've
mm-hmm.
had some experiences in this house.
Mm-hmm.
Again, upstairs, I was actually opening this house, and I was in the house by myself.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, as I was opening up the window,
mm-hmm.
all of a sudden the room erupted in noise. Like there was no movement, but it sounded like a flurry of activity around me, of clothes rustling, of
wow.
people moving, and there was no discernible
mm-hmm.
movement or anything that happened.
Mm-hmm.
But it lasted for about 15 seconds, which was a really long time because I froze as it was just swirling and swirling and swirling, and then it just stopped.
Yeah.
Like,
neat. See, yeah, that's, if y'all don't mind, we want to go to that hot spot, like I said, with the pennant and see
yeah,
what we can get
absolutely.
Right quick before you close.
Sure.
Yeah.
It's upstairs.
Okay. Okay.
Until she gets back in.
Okay. Oh, well, I can.
She should be right. I mean, she's
yeah,
here.
I can wait. I guess you, if you, well, you said you can't go nowhere. Okay. Yeah, they've done a lot of work in here lately, haven't they?
Yeah.
Because the last time I came with my interior design class.
Oh, that was a little different.
Yeah, it was a little bit different.
So this is the room where all three of us saw the figure.
Okay.
That's the room where I experienced the noise, but nothing was moving. And then this room has always given me an unsettled feeling.
Okay, you didn't like the one in
there.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let me grab my phone.
Yeah, glass. It was done by a contemporary glass artist. Pretty cool. She did all that 2 weeks.
That's the pendant. Gonna see if it can move around. If grab my back, Shana. We're gonna. Okay. I'm gonna walk through here a little bit and see if it's gonna move anything. But you don't like this room?
It's like every once in a while I get a good feeling. And it's not like an angry feeling. It's like I'm not welcome here kind of feeling. It's not all the time. It's every once in a while I'll feel it.
Yeah. I'm trying to see what the pendant is. It is shaking. Oh, I gotta let them see that it's shaking. Is there a spirit here in this place at the moment? If so, make the pendant go around to the left. Yeah. Can I sit on the floor?
Yeah.
Okay.
I can also
that might be easier. See, it's moving. They want to move it. Thank you.
What's in there?
Just copper. Okay, thank you. See, they're moving it to the left. See, it's moving to the left. There you go. There you go. See it? Yeah, it's moving. And I can feel the vibration from it. And is it a spirit with some sort of animosity? Move to the left if yes. Yes, it has animosity. Ooh, look at that. Lots of animosity. Whoa. Was this once your home? Move it to the right if yes. Move it to the left if no. Was this your home? Was this your home? They're saying no. They're moving it to the right a little bit. Yeah, they're moving it to the, trying to move it to the right.
I was about to say, the Myers had people who were enslaved.
Okay.
And they would have come out to be stored here and been in this space, so it's possible.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. I'm gonna use my right hand because my left arm is hurting real bad. Was Africa your home? Was Africa your home? You can move it to the left if yes. If Africa was your home, move it to the left. Or was America your home? First, answer if Africa was your home. And you can move it to the left. Okay. They're saying no, Africa was not their home. They're moving it to the right. Right? You see them moving it right? So, was America your home? Or was it named something else? Move it to the left if America was your home and it was just called something else. Was America your home and it was called something else?
Why do we need a Ouija board?
They're kind of neutral on that one.
Board?
I don't think they know their home. Were you a child? Were you a child? You move it to the left if you were a child. Were you a child? Move it erratically to the left if you were a child. Move it, spin it where I can really feel it. Yeah, see, they're spinning it really good.
They're a kid?
See, they're spinning it.
Can I
No. Yeah, it's like you said, it's more like a slave spirit, an enslaved spirit here, I would say. Because they weren't slaves. They were slaves, what you all call slaves, but what I know as my ancestors, they were enslaved, you know. Yeah.
Their only identity.
Yeah, that's not their identity. Yeah. Right. Mm-hmm. So. Yeah. So that's the problem you feel in here. Yeah, that's why you feel like that. I feel like that sometimes. I can be driving around my old hometown and like I want to do something, but the spirits won't allow me. They block me for some reason. Maybe there's danger there.
Yeah.
Yeah. But they said they have animosity. And you said we can go down there? That's where the slaves were too?
Yes.
Is that the kitchen?
No, so they moved to, this is where they were probably store linens and things.
Okay.
Maybe the space that the slaves would use.
Okay.
That's the
basement.
Okay.
They would have a back staircase
in houses like this. So they can the houses. Okay. I'm going to ask the spirits, because I went to the fairy house and the nanny, she feared me walking in the room. She hid behind the psychic lady. So, do you fear me? Turn it to the left or the right if you fear me. Left for yes, right for no. Okay, no, you don't fear me? That's good. That's good. You don't fear me. Okay. Okay, okay, okay. Saying that doesn't fear me. Okay.
Can we hold that glass
broken? Yeah, some of the glass is broken.
How?
Well, over time, sometimes squirrels have gotten inside and they've knocked some things down.
Oh, okay.
Sometimes pieces fall over.
So these are the stuff that came with the house?
That's actually all by my contemporary glass artist. So it's only a few years ago.
Oh, okay. For the museum. Okay.
Yeah.
Nice.
Why are there two chimneys?
Yeah, the chimney's nice, ain't it? What's a necessary room?
Yeah, so it's a bathroom.
Okay.
Which wasn't original to the house. And the chimney was added later, so that wasn't in this space originally. It was added by one of the generations later.
Mm-hmm. So you don't know no names of the slaves or anything?
There was Billy.
Billy?
Billy was a cooper.
Okay.
He was a barrel maker. So they had anywhere from 6 to 12, depending on the time.
Mm-hmm.
There was
can we sit in these seats?
Yeah, absolutely. Okay. Yeah, all of these are
what? Fine. You heard a noise? Okay. So, and who else was in here?
So we don't know who would have slept in this room. Because the Myers family don't talk about it. But we know Billy was one of their one of the people who was enslaved. There was Robin. There was.
It looks like the house caught on fire.
Well, the house didn't really catch on fire, although that's always a risk. So some of this is old, newer construction. Over different renovation periods, they've done different things to the house.
Mm-hmm.
There was Drusilla.
Priscilla or Drusilla?
Drusilla.
So Robin, Drusilla, Billy.
Yeah, those at least are three of them.
Okay. Is it Drusilla, left for yes, right for no? Are you Drusilla? Left, it's saying no, it's not Drusilla. No. Did I say left for?
Well, yes, ma'am.
Okay, is it Billy? Left for yes, right for no. Is it Billy? Is Billy here?
Most of the spirit is part of the house.
Okay, I'm gonna ask again. Is it Drusilla, left for yes, right for no? Is Drusilla here? Yes, it's Drusilla. Drusilla's here. Yes, it's Drusilla. And she's making it spend, she's making it spend erratically. Thank you, Drusilla, for being clear.
I'm gonna hold it.
Children. Yeah. So, okay, he wanted to ask a question. Let me go way up here.
You saw something? You did the video?
Oh, you were asking, is there anyone buried here? Did they bury them here?
They would have had graveyards around that they would have buried them in, but people would have died in the house.
Okay. Was there any slaves buried here, Drusilla? Left for yes, right for no.
I think the ghost is only seen from the grandma.
She's saying yes, there's slaves buried here. And she's doing it erratically. You see? Wow. And I was gonna use the Apple app to communicate, but I didn't like that too much. The pendant, you can't never go wrong with the pendant and communication.
Yeah.
But the other stuff is. All right, now that we've received communication, we asked a couple of questions. I guess we can finish touring with the girls, for the girls.
Oh, yeah.
Seeing the rest of the house. But this is just one spot here. Go on ahead, Shahana. In that room. Watch out. I love this bedroom. I need to design lines like this. I think that bed is awfully uncomfortable.
It does not look very.
Yeah, that's the only thing. We have a modern day mattress on it. But it looks like a nice little cozy bedroom.
Yeah,
it
looks
nice. That looks like hot.
It's a bed warmer. So they would put hot poles in the bed warmer instead of under the sheets.
That's where we came from.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. So, yes. So how many bedrooms is in here?
It's cold.
I know, it's cold. Damn it.
So, four is warm, and the attic space where the kids were, there are three bedrooms in there. This was there.
Okay. Don't he look like, I know last time I came here, I said he looks like the guy on CNN.
Oh, yeah.
Don't he look, everybody says that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's part of my, he was the last one in the
house. Okay.
Back in the 1930s. He died in the late 1920s, and then his wife turned the house over to the city of Norfolk with everything inside, so that the, his wife is not full alive. Some of their kids are now dead too.
Mm-hmm.
She's dead and he's dead. And then some of their kids are also dead at this point. They were so big, yes. So long.
What about their kids? Mm-hmm.
Well, in the original family, three children died in infancy. And nine of the children from the Myers family lived to adulthood. The three died.
My 14-year-old is asking about their generational children. Do they have any children?
So there
great, 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 great.
Yeah, so there's a guy who lives, a descendant who was the last Meyer to be born in the house, lives out in California,
mm-hmm.
And he has one daughter, and he's still alive. Mm-hmm. And just recently, a descendant of the family that lived around this area died. I want to say that. And she was the first Meyer to be born, not in the house.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to say she has a niece who's still in the area that's still related to them, but I've never met her.
Oh.
Yeah, the house is full of noises.
Yeah, I can't hear anything. Cause,
you just hear the
fan. Yeah, just the fan.
I hear weird
noises. You hear weird noises? I just hear the fan. So this is it for upstairs, huh?
Yeah,
it's small.
Had
okay.
But I just
so it's Drusilla and she has animosity. Let me see. Let me see if she feels entrapped. That's the last question. Well, if she feels entrapped, and does she want to be released? Okay. Drusilla, do you feel entrapped in this house? Left for yes, right for no. And move it erratically. Left for yes, right for no. Do you feel entrapped in this house, Drusilla? She's confused, evidently. Because she may not be trapped. Soul may be free to go where they want. I don't know. It's just maybe, I don't know. I'm not getting an answer. Do you feel trapped in this house? Okay, now she's, you feel trapped in this house? Let me know. Move it erratically to the left, towards the left direction. It's something trapping you here. There, no, because I got it on camera. Go away. Move it erratically to the left. She says she feels trapped. Maybe her energy is low because she had a hard time trying to decipher in the beginning or come through. Okay. Is there something, you said it's something trapping you here? Move to the left, if yes. If there's something trapping you here, move it to the left erratically. Erratically. Okay, she says yes, she feels entrapped. Is it memories that are trapping you here? Yes or no? Left for yes, right for no. Yes, she says yes, it's the memories. And it's erratically moving. She's erratically moving it. Well, let's tour the rest of downstairs. Shana, don't lose my stuff. I got stuff in there, baby. Did you lose my crystal that I have in here? Okay, don't lose my stuff. Yeah, come on. You probably lose this necklace. Hold the bag for me. Okay. Is there, can we go up?
Yeah, so there's a gate at the top of the steps. You can't go on the floor itself because of fire regulation. Okay.
You can
go up to take a peek if you'd like.
Okay.
It's certainly where all the kids were, and they did have their children die in the
museum. Okay, died and as babies?
Yeah.
Okay, do you ever hear any crying? Baby crying?
No.
Okay. Yeah, like in the fairy house, I saw a little girl in there, and nobody had a little girl.
Right. That's what's sort of confusing about this one. I mean, in the later generation, but the original
ones, not the kids
that died, the girl with the younger.
Okay.
That's a crib, a baby crib.
Mm-hmm. Was there a little girl that passed away in here? Let's say about 5 or 4. Left for yes, right for no. She's spinning it erratically. Okay. Did the little girl pass in the 1930s or did she pass in 1800s? Yes or no? For 1930s, yes. No, if it wasn't 1930s. Okay. They're saying the little girl passed in 1930s. Go. When they saw her, what was she wearing? Were they able to describe her?
He could describe her, but I don't remember exactly what it was. Mm-hmm.
Right. Yeah, because 1930s.
Yeah.
Right. They didn't say why the house was turned over in 1930. I know he passed. When
He passed, and then she couldn't take care of it anymore, and her kids weren't interested, so she just turned the house over. It was too much for her.
Okay. But it was the daughter that took care of her father in old age, right? One of the youngest daughter?
For the original generation?
Yeah. The 1832, I think the daughter died in what, 18? The youngest died in 1856. 16. Okay, 16. Okay.
Yes, there were two little girls who passed away in the family. I'm not sure if she passed away in the home, but basically Moses Myers II had two small daughters that passed away in 1862 as well. And I think one was 4 and one was 6.
Okay.
And then there is, so we had a group of retirees come in a busload, and some of them couldn't all go upstairs because, you know, stairs are hard, so some of them stayed down here. And while we were standing here talking to the ones who couldn't go upstairs, she asked us if there was another family in the house, and we said, no, your tour group is the only group that's in here. And she says that she'd seen a little girl come down the stairs, peek over the railing, and run back up, and that she was wearing like a red taffeta dress.
Okay.
So
is that 1930s to you?
There may have been. I'm not sure if there were any in the 1930s, but because really the house became a museum in 1931.
Okay. Okay.
So the family didn't live here anymore after that. But I will show you this one picture. So there is a picture of the little girl. So here, there's a little girl in that window.
Okay, I see. But
that's the family member, you know, alive, of course. And I have a picture of that zoomed in. Let me see if I can find it. So here she is. That's a zoomed in picture.
Okay. So what year was this?
This is circa 1870.
Okay.
And there's somebody else in the other window over here. This is just the two images put together, but there's somebody else in that other window too.
Do they know if that one was a live person in the 1870s?
Oh yeah, yeah.
Okay, they're both
a live person. But
they both were. Okay.
Are we in their house?
Yeah, we're in their house right now. This is their house.
Mm-hmm.
And that's little girl, and this lady is in the other window right there.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Is that her mom? Might be. Might be her mom.
Okay. So that's okay.
Yeah.
So is there the kitchen separated from the house? Can we go see that?
Yeah.
Can we see that real quick?
Yeah, I'll
take them out. Okay.
You can go out there when there's no
one. Oh, okay.
That's why Karen's my boss.
Oh, okay.
I just refer to my boss.
Call me if you need me. We'll go this way.
Okay.
And don't forget your umbrella.
Yeah, because we want to go to the courtyard and see the yard before we leave. Yeah. So this is the rest of the house. Uh-huh.
That's not a real bird. Bird. Alright, so watch your step here over this threshold.
Okay. Girls, watch your step. Are they trying to build a kitchen here? They're trying to do a kitchen here.
This was a hyphen, so this was always a pass-through area that led from the kitchen into the house.
So what's all that back there?
So that is where that leads to the dining room.
Okay, the room we were in.
So this is where they put their Victorian kitchen during the Victorian time period, but all that got ripped out in the 60s.
Okay.
Yeah. So let's go into the old kitchen, and when we go, let's go first now.
Okay.
Close this door behind us.
Mm-hmm. I told you to bring some for your hair. No, y'all share. You can share. Come on, get under there. Get under there. It's only a second. Come on.
Sorry. Okay. Alright, so this is a room that
would've
been shared by the people who were enslaved in the house.
Okay, so Drusilla would have worked in here.
Drusilla and her daughter Chaney would have worked here.
Okay.
And the cook, who we think was Hagar.
It's not real food.
It's not real food. It's fake food.
Mm-hmm.
Is it just a hard walk? It's
kind of
like plastic almost.
Yeah. So... Drusilla, did you work in this room? Yes, for left, right, for no. See, she's saying yes. She's saying yes.
Yeah, so these stones came off of one of Moses' ships in the 1790s. And one time, Cook and one of the other enslaved servants named Jim, they got cholera, which was a very bad illness, and they would have been in this room, and to cure them, they gave them boiled lemonade, which was good, and castor oil, very bad, but Jim and Cook lived.
Mm-hmm. That's good.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm going to ask her if she's got any family members that she knows. Because, yeah, I mean, you don't know much about Drusilla. You said she had a child?
Yes.
And then did they stay in the area?
We don't know. We would love to find out.
Okay. Drusilla, from your daughter, do you have any great-great? Do you have children that are in the area, great descendants that are in the Norfolk area or this Virginia area? Yes for left, right for no. Reba, Shahana. Left for yes, right for no. I don't think she understands the question. They get confused.
So sometimes I've heard them do back and like swinging.
Uh-huh.
Yes,
oh, swing.
And circling for
okay.
No.
Yeah.
Yeah, so swinging can be yes, circling can be no.
Did you see the swinging?
A little bit, yeah.
Okay. Oh, there's the swinging.
So
oh, so they probably no, used no, to the swinging. Do you have descendants? So you, is yes, is the, are you swinging it for yes? Okay, yeah, she's swinging it erratically, as you can see. Yeah, so she does have descendants here.
Yes, yeah. We would love to find
Do you often visit your descendants, or are you, do you think you're just bounded to this place for some reason? Someone put in your mind that you're bounded to this place. Do you visit your descendants? Are you able to get out? You said circular for no?
Yeah, circular for no.
Circular for no and swing it back and forth for yes.
Yeah.
Swing it for yes. She said yes. She's swinging it back and forth. You're like, I can really feel the energy from it. Yeah, she's saying yes. So let me ask that again, because it might have been some confusion, but I did tell her left, swing it right. That's how I did it. I guess either way it can go. Okay.
Did he put the faces right here?
Is this Drusilla I'm speaking with now? Swing it erratically, back and forth, erratically, if this is Drusilla. If you are Drusilla I'm speaking with, and I spoke to you upstairs, swing it back and forth erratically. I'm gonna give you some time. This is the last question. Then I gotta go. You are Drusilla? Swing it back and forth. You are Drusilla? Okay. This is Drusilla.
Everything's like
200
years old.
So I'm trying to think. Because she said she wasn't from Africa. She just didn't say she was from America. I don't know where she could have been from.
We do know in the bill of sale for Drusilla and Cheney that it follows them from a man named James Gleason, mm-hmm. and then sold them to William Hickman. And mm-hmm. William Hickman was from Bedford, Tennessee.
Okay.
So I don't know if Drusilla and Cheney came from Tennessee, or mm-hmm. if they just were threatened with being taken to Tennessee mm-hmm. from here. I don't know if they're from Virginia or Tennessee or somewhere else.
Okay.
There's only one piece in this room that seems for the actual belonging.
I know. You said what's the actual belonging?
The actual belonging of the people who were enslaved here, and this is this vessel right here.
Oh, nice.
This was original, and they found this buried under the stairs in the back of the house. Goodness.
And that belonged to them.
Mm-hmm.
They don't know. Who did that belong to? Billy, yeah. Perhaps?
Yeah, they don't really know.
Because they handmade it, didn't they?
Yeah, it looks handmade. It could belong to Hagar. The cook, we believe Hagar was the cook, but it looks like it was made to hold something cold, like butter.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, those do look real.
Or not hold water?
Yeah, it could hold water. It could, but the reason we think it was meant to hold something cold is it was buried under the back of the stairs.
Okay,
they didn't
and it's
have
cool
there. So mm-hmm. they would bury things to keep mm-hmm. them cold.
Mm-hmm. Hmm.
There's spider. Yeah, there's like a spider leg in here.
All right. Well, we really appreciate it.
Well,
have a good time.
Thank you all so much. And mm-hmm. I hope you will come back and see us and tell your friends.
Definitely. So this is the courtyard right here. It's such a beautiful yard. Such a beautiful yard. They have this was a huge yard. River, give it. Share it with
get
you. Share it. You can get under it. All right, we're ready to go. So I'm gonna close out on this note and let you all see the yard. We got to experience talking with Drusilla, one of the ancestors that unfortunately had to be enslaved in this home. And like I said, most of the people that we usually come in contact with is not gonna be necessarily always the owner of the house. It's you.
Ooh. Umbrella in my car. You can have this one.
Thank you so much. Thank you so
You're
much. Have a good
welcome.
One. Okay, you too. Reba, give her her umbrella back.
It doesn't matter.
No, she wants hers. Switch hers. Switch it real quick, please. Okay. Put them not thank you. So we're gonna walk on out of here and head towards our car now. But I'm gonna close it out on this beautiful scene here because look, I mean, I'm trying to get you all to see the scale of the beauty of this yard.
What's that skeleton?
Hold on, Reba. I don't think I can show enough. Watch out. But we're gonna go over here and see. They got a little sitting area. Ain't that beautiful? But I'm gonna close out with that. I'm gonna close out with that. So always remember, thank you guys for being here. Have a peaceful, beautiful day. And with that said, true love, real peace. And know that our loved ones are always around us. She said she visits her family. And we have to horn in on that. Home in on that and engage with them. With that said, true love, real peace, the higher self within, the soul. Till next time, peace, family. Thank you for being here and have a lovely day.